Good afternoon and welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett and this afternoon we're going to take a look at how we can manage and understand our MySQL users. As always, you're able to find these videos on theurbanpenguin.com. If you're on Twitter, you're able to follow me at The Urban Penguin, and on Facebook you're going to find my page as The Urban Penguin. So I'll be using Linux in this demonstration, so if we get onto my SUSE Linux server, which is also acting as my MySQL server, we're going to enter the MySQL client and I'm going to log on as the administrative user root. If I go minus u root and then just minus p, it's going to prompt me for the MySQL root user's password. If I need to access via a script, then I could provide the password at the command line, but the password is pushed right up against the minus p. There can't be a space between the minus p and the password. For obvious reasons, you might not want to include the password in a command line script. If we want to display what users we have, currently this is a new system and I only have the root user. They're in one of our system databases. So I'm going to go through, I'm going to select user from the MySQL database and the table user. And a semicolon at the end of my line. And it might look a little bit confusing because it might appear that I've got three root users. But we identify the user by the username and the host. If we've secured the system, root will only be able to log on from the local host, but we can specify that in IP version 4, IP version 6, or within the host name itself, localhost. So we have the three entries. When I'm creating new users, I can just specify create user and then the name of the user. It doesn't need to be quoted unless we're including special characters in the name. So I'm just going to create my user. I will put the quotes in, but as I say, they're not necessary for a user called Bob. Now when we go through and take a look at the select user statement, we have Bob, and we're using a similar wildcard to the like format. So percent means from any character, and we've got no characters surrounding it, so it really is from any host. If we want to go through and take a look at the password field here, we can see as we scroll down a little bit that we've not created Bob's password. So we've created the user, but we didn't set a password. Let's go now and drop the user. So this is deleting the user account or the MySQL user account. And we're going to go back now and create our user Bob, but we're going to specify the host name. So we're going to choose Bob and then at. And certainly the at element itself is not going to be quoted out, but we can quote out the host names. That could be localhost, or it could be something like star.tup.com, or we could put IP address or IP address ranges within there. I'm going to put this back to be just Bob at localhost, so that Bob will be able to connect from the local machine, whether it's IP version 4 or IP version 6. But we're going to include his password here. So we're going to then use the keyword identified by, and then as a quoted string, the password that we would like Bob to be able to use. So we identify ourselves as being the real Mr. Bob by providing the password that we have here. And again, as always, there are semicolons at the end of our statements. If we go through now with the select statement, we can see that Bob has in fact not the password that we set, but an encrypted version. So the password function itself is encrypting the password. Again, let's just go through and try dropping the user, but it's not going to allow me to do it because my user is no longer Bob or Bob at percent now. We have to drop the user Bob at localhost. So it doesn't mean that we can have multiple user names from different systems. Again, let me just use system clear to clear the screen. And then again, we'll create the Bob again, but we'll just use the default. So it will Bob from any host. And we'll set his password. So the password can be created when we create the user. But of course, we can change the password later. So we can then go through and set the password for Bob. But again, we use the password function here, whereas we called it before by using identified by. So now the password is set, we'll be able to exit out of this because currently we are running as root. So if we exit or log out of the MySQL client, doesn't matter who we're logged into, Linux or Windows, whatever client we're using, we happen to be using a Linux client here. And I'm going to prompt for the password, and we're going to be minus u Bob. Throw in our password. So that was capital P password. And then as we get in, we can clear the screen. So again, system clear. System clear exists on a Linux system. And then we could display the current user. So select current underscore user and then our brackets will show me that I'm logged in as Bob percent. So hopefully this explains a little bit about the usernames and how we create and manage our users on a MySQL system. And we've identified things like the percent and the localhost as our host names.